Okay, this video is for Old Mill unit number 332. It's gonna be located on the top floor in the north building. This one has really done quite a bit in the way of remodeling. So you'll notice here they put in this pergo wood flooring. That's gonna stretch all the way back into the kitchen as well, back into the hall, into the bedrooms there. Looks really nice. Also, you'll notice on these, I should probably turn on the light there, that these doors have been replaced out here with a panel door. Originally, these would have been a wood grain door, and there's quite a few doors in Old Mill. It costs about $1,000 to $1,500 just in the doors alone to replace them out. So, I just showed you the coat closet. Old Mill, you'll see, will have lots and lots of storage, both in the bedrooms as well as outside of the bedrooms. Carpet here, carpet actually looks in really good shape. We've got a leather sofa right there, and then these will have a balcony right off the living room here. And then these fireplaces here, just kind of for looks, they don't really work, but it is there. Old Mills are about 1,344 square feet, so they're actually some of the largest of the student condos. Some of the largest in both the room size as well as the family room and other living areas. So right here's the kitchen. So you'll notice that the stove has been replaced out from the original ones. We've got over the range microwave. Blinds are up, but you've got 2-inch blinds. This is kind of cool about being here in the north building, is that kind of this wooded in feel there. And then shot of the cabinets. Fridge has also been and the dishwasher has been replaced out from the original as well. And these are going to have the natural oak cabinets on it. So going on back, and I always try to point this out on Old Mill, I like how they angle the hallway, so they offset it here so that you have to actually go down and around before you can see into the bedroom area. So it gives the students a lot more privacy that way. So right here is going to be the furnace and water heater room. Old Mill is going to have gas furnace, gas water heater, and central air conditioning. So there's a shot of the furnace right there. So heading on down the hall, kind of just all the rooms are gonna be basically very similar. So this room right here, you'll notice that they all have full-size beds, 6-drawer dressers. If you look at the size of closet, the closet sizes in Old Mill are really bigger than a lot of the shared rooms that I'll see. And then you have these shared tub showers right here. These will have locks on them too, so the girls can, you know, lock off both their bedroom as well as the when they're inside the shower, they can do that. There also is jacuzzi jet controls on both sides, but I don't know too many that actually use the jacuzzi tubs. Then this is really cool. So each bedroom's gonna have their own half bath, their own toilet, vanity, and sink. All these bathrooms will have tile floors on them, which was, of course, not original. There's gonna be a shot of the toilet right there. Across the way here, same type of a thing, where you can see her full-size bed right there. We got the 2-inch blinds. She's removed the closet doors off of her closet, which is actually very common to see all over the place. And then right here, again, it's going to be the tub and shower, and then she's going to have her half bath right here, again with the tile floors. So you can see how she's got all of her makeup and stuff over to the side of her sink, and that's one thing that's really cool about the Old Mills, that they have plenty of space to put that kind of stuff. Here at the end of the hall, you have a nice big storage closet. You'll notice that there's some of the closet doors in here. So this room right here, again, 6-drawer dresser, full-size bed. Here's going to be her half bath with the tile floor. So this is opposite the room we were just in, would be right behind that door. And then this, just putting up some curtains here, but this would go right into the tub and shower like we saw before. So there's the 2-inch blinds, it's kind of panning around the other direction. And then a shot of her closet right there. Another thing that's kind of neat on these as well is Old Mill is going to be one of the few that actually has the fire sprinklers in addition to the normal thing. So, okay, so our last bedroom here. So there's going to be the access to the bathroom there, and then the the half bath right there, and then the other room that we saw right behind this wall would be the half bath for that room. Thanks, you guys. So moving on down here, Old Mill is a really big project. We're going to have there's 97 units in Old Mill, two BYU student wards just by itself. So it's a big project. So we'll kind of take a quick tour here so you can see the layout and some of the different amenities that it has. So this area they put in about a year and a half ago, used to be trees and that sort of thing. They fenced off the cul-de-sac right here because it's mostly families, and they try to keep the little kids out of the area. They put in these little barbecue centers with there's umbrellas that go with the tables. It just hasn't gotten to that point of the year yet when they get that done. Going on down this way, we're going to have this building right here is going to be an all-female building. Off to our right will be an all-men's building. Off to our left would be an all-female building. Both of these two buildings right here will have outdoor pools. And then right in front of us is going to be the Solarium building, which is half boys, half guys, and that will have the year-round tropical pool. So, okay, so just really quick, get my little key out here. Okay, so this is going to be one of the two outdoor pools here. And you can see that it's open right to the sky. So this is going to be a seasonal pool, and will be open for the spring and summer, and then they shut down in the winter time. So kind of an interesting fact, I guess, up here on the top of this stairwell, and then back on the top of this stairwell right here, they actually have two offices that they let the bishops use of the two wards that Old Mill creates, the YSA wards. So they can use it for doing interviews and whatnot, that way without it, the kids having to go all the way to the school. So there's going to be our second pool here, and this little gazebo basically is where the pump house is and the heater is for the pool. So we'll keep on wandering through. Like I said, Old Mill is pretty big. Okay. So continuing on to the solarium here. Now, also, anybody in any of the buildings can use any of the facilities. It doesn't so much matter, where you're at that way. So, okay, so here's our solarium pool. So this one is a little bit different because this is going to be open year-round. And so you'll notice all these tropical plants that are growing inside here. And you'll notice that it's all covered in here on the top. So even in the dead of winter, when it's 10 degrees outside, it's still 70 to 80 degrees inside this solarium. So pretty cool amenity for the students to use. You got a little ping pong table down below. Gazebo up here where they used to kind of sitting and hanging out, and then we've got a beach sand volleyball right here, which is also open year-round, complete with their customized logo volleyball net there. So and then we've almost made it to the front of the project, so you head out this way. So now we're on the south side. This is going to be 1720 north and then 724 west. And so definitely right in the middle of student land basically here. So We've got Crestwood, which would be right up the hill over there, which is all single students, and Branbury Park would be right down here, end of the road, and then Carriage Cove is right next door, and then Riverside would be just around the corner. So right there, you can see the blue sign. That's going to be the bus route. There'll be a bus. It's route number 831 that I believe services both UVU and BYU campus, and shuttles the kids back and forth. So you can drive. There's actually quite a bit of parking here compared to most student complexes, or, you know, hop on the bus and you know, leave the driving up to somebody else. So anyway, that would be the video tour for Old Mill 332.